storms. Mary May is tracking what we can expect. Mary.
All right, guys. Yeah, that heat definitely gives these storms the energy they need to become a little bit strong. Some of these producing gusty winds and also some hail. Not seeing any active warnings right now, but you do have a thunderstorm over Guthrie. This is heading in toward Allensville. We've had a little bit of hail with this as well around Guthrie. Keeping a close eye on this storm that's kind of bubbling up around Lebanon. It's continuing to stay in place, mainly stationary. These storms really aren't moving much. Northern edge of Todd County, just south of Kirkmansville. Also, we're watching a little thunderstorm there. We have one moving into Dixon County. Tennessee City getting some rain, and you'll see some heavy rain shortly. The outlook for the rest of today, a marginal risk. This continues into tonight, and that's level 1 out of 5. And that just means that some of these storms may briefly reach those severe limits. We've already seen that a couple of times this afternoon. Damaging winds, a little bit of hail, and downpours are going to be the main threats. Now, if you take a look here, you can see there is a stalled out frontal boundary. As this starts to move in the next couple of days, we're actually going to see an increased chance for showers and thunderstorms. A lot of moisture to our south. You can see it's pretty stormy across pretty much all of the southeast. So a very summer-like weather pattern the remainder of this evening. Notice we'll continue to see these storms popping up, and then they'll start to fall apart. This continues into tonight. Tomorrow morning, you'll likely wake up to a little bit of patchy fog, and then we do it all over again tomorrow afternoon and evening as storms continue across the board. Tomorrow, the severe weather threat is almost exactly the same as it is today. It's a marginal risk along and north of 40. All of southern Kentucky included in this, and a good portion of middle Tennessee. And the threats remain the same, mainly damaging winds, small hail, and those downpours that could lead to localized flooding. Here's a view of our Donaldson Air Heating and Air Conditioning Experts camera. 90 degrees and looking pretty dark there in Dixon. And as I showed you earlier on radar, we do have some rain on the way. 90 in Columbia, 92 Cookeville. We're not quite as hot as we were yesterday, but it certainly feels just as hot. We have very high humidity. Feels like temperatures still in the triple digits. Feeling like 103 right now in Clarksville. 100 is what it feels like in Shelbyville. Even feeling like the 90s. Cookeville, 97. It feels like 91 in Jamestown. Those higher elevations, pretty sweltering for you folks. You're usually a lot cooler than the rest of us. The trend will actually increase in terms of our temperatures as we head into the weekend. We'll be a little cooler over the next couple of days, but still above average. And that's because we'll see better rain chances tomorrow and Thursday. A little bit more action when it comes to showers and thunderstorms. So here's a look at Thursday. Notice scattered afternoon and evening thunderstorms. And we'll see rain again on Friday as well. Your lows tonight, low and mid-70s, pretty typical. Just a reminder, we will likely see a little bit of patchy fog. You'll see upper 60s in those higher elevations. Highs tomorrow, not quite as hot, but it's going to feel close to 100 when you factor in the humidity. We're looking at 91 Columbia, 92 Nashville, 89 Hopkinsville. We'll see 87 in Crossville. If you don't have our weather app, it comes in handy, trust me, especially over the next week when we have so many thunderstorms in the forecast. Free radar, just search for WKRN Weather in the App Store or the Google Play Store. It's easy and free. There's no reason why you shouldn't download it. Scattered storms continuing through the end of the week. Highs, mid-90s. Notice we'll see just a few hit or miss storms Saturday and Sunday. So you should have a fairly pleasant weekend, but it's going to be hot. We're talking 95 both Saturday and Sunday, and the humidity sticking around. This summertime pattern is not coming to an end anytime soon. So just make sure you keep an eye out. If you start to hear the rumble of thunder, head indoors until the storm passes.
Mary, thank you so much. We had the tornado, then the pandemic, both rocking East Nashville, but there are some signs of recovery. We have special reports on East Nashville rebuilding all day Thursday on News 2 and every newscast.
And getting ready.